Secretary, I have a couple of questions.
Yes, sir.
I was glad to see that when you let off in your remarks, one of the first things that you said was we need to rebuild trust. I had a forum in my home city of Attleboro talking about the gas tax, and we presented the benefits. And I think it was clearly a trust area. People were, I don't think that they would have necessarily huge problems. They knew it was going to go to the stated purpose, but they just don't believe us from a trust standpoint. And a lot of folks talked about the fact that the unemployment rate is so high, people are struggling, and there's a lot of cutbacks. And you mentioned the 300 jobs I think the term is right-sizing.
Yes.
But none of us has a perspective of what that 300 jobs means in terms of percent of the overall workforce. Can you give us some sense of what the 300 jobs means in terms of percentage of the whole workforce?
I would ask Frank and Alan to about the combined workforce of the Highway Department Turnpike.
1,900,
that's highway. 1,300, so again, I'm an English major. But
what did you say, 1,400?
1,300 and 1,900, respectively. So, you know, we're estimating 300 jobs, and you know, look, here's my view. Let's talk about trust and this issue, because they're intertwined. We have to do the downsizing and the right sizing, because it's the right thing to do, because as we consolidate, we have to squeeze out efficiencies. We have to do it. It doesn't give me pleasure to do it. I've said it, I'm going to say it publicly again. It doesn't give me any pleasure to do it, nor doesn't give anyone up here any pleasure to do it, because no one wants to see people out of work. I mean, the two most important things for people are a job and their health. Everything else is gravy. So putting people out of work, we don't do lightly, but it has to be done because we have to have an efficient system that people can have confidence in and restore that trust that they have lost. And I know that they've lost it because I go around the state in this job, and I've been to Worcester, and I've been to Springfield and Chicopee, and now in Methuen, I've been out to the Berkshires, and I know it. And we can all talk about the reasons why they've lost trust, things that have happened over the course of the past decade or more. I'm here to say what I'm doing as secretary is saying I'm kind of burying my soul. You know, sometimes I get in trouble for burying my soul. I get a little passionate about it, and I'm learning. But I have to. I have to demonstrate that I mean what I say. I have to demonstrate to you, and I'll come down to Attleboro, and that I mean what I say, that I care about GATRA, and I care about the commuter rail service, and in your high priority projects for road and bridge. But I can't come
up. I believe you do.
But I frankly, Representative, the only way I know how to restore trust is to show people that we mean it, and then I have to deliver. And I will do that to the best of my ability. I can't do it with an empty wallet, which is part of the reason why we're having this conversation.
That leads to my second question. On the first one, I just want to make sure I heard it right. Did you say 1,300 in one agency and 1,900
that's
in
the
other?
Yes, correct.
Okay, so the total would be the addition. And that's over a 2 or 3 year period?
Well, I think we would do it quickly. It might be over a 1 year period. We're gonna consolidate. If you get this bill passed, this consolidation will happen next year. And people will begin that process. And we will. I've talked to Alan Lubovich and the commissioner, and we are already thinking ahead about how do we hit the ground running on that consolidation. And you know, that means dealing with a whole host of issues, not the least of which are things like collective bargaining agreements, normalizing them, and because you can't have an engineer from the Turnpike now working in the same division as an engineer in the Highway Department making different salaries and benefits. So we're going to have to normalize all that. And I know all of these things come with pros and cons, but I think it has to be done. Just like at the T, you've got to have those reforms because I don't think that achieving parity with your fellow state employee is punitive. I would say that with all respect to my friends in organized labor. Parity is not punitive. And we'll try to achieve that because we should all be fair, but we can't have the system that we have today.
Now, if I, for the second question, if I just go back for a moment to the
yes,
reforms, sometimes when you're talking to constituents, you get interesting observations. And one of the observations that was made to me by one of my constituents is you folks have been talking about reforms for a long time. And now you're talking about the promise of reforms along with the gas tax. He said, why haven't you done the reforms already? Why don't you pass the reform package first and then come back and ask us for gas tax and we might be more willing? And specifically what this constituent said is, I feel a whole lot better if you consolidated the agencies first. And I feel better if you addressed the pension and the abuses and the 23 and out, because in this constituent's mind, that doesn't cost us anything to do, to implement the reforms. So could you perhaps share whether what your willingness might be to do this as a two-stage process?
I think the answer is, Representative, that we need to act on both this year. And look, if we had the luxury, if I had the luxury of saying we'll do something now and wait 2 years, I would tell you that, but we don't have that luxury. We are, the crisis is now. $7 tolls at the tunnels is happening this year. Stress on the MBTA, as Representative Schettino pointed out, is happening this year. That's not something that we did. It's not something that you did. It's something we all inherited. But here we are. So what I say is, let's get the reforms done and started now. We've already took on the flaggers. That's a reform that's happening this spring construction season. We put the service clauses of the turnpike out to bid. No more. We are beginning the process. We've laid off enough people to save $31 million on the turnpike. Out of work in this economy, that's reform. 41% drop in overtime at the T. So we've started that, but we need this bill to complete it. And we will complete it with all due speed. And we can put milestones in this bill for reform, because I'm happy to be judged by the standard. Happy to do that. But nothing that we can do on the reform side is going to prevent the kinds of fiscal catastrophes that are presented to us at the turnpike or at the T or at the regional transit authorities. They need help this year. So I appreciate the sentiment. And I've been on the job for 2 months, right? So, and I'm not going to, someone at the Representative Wagner's district, and those of you from the Pioneer Valley, was on they had me calling into a rock radio call-in thing in the morning, and I did it. And they began, you know how those radio shows are, so the fellow who was doing the show started off by saying, I'll use a euphemism, I'm ticked off, he said. He used a different word. And I said, I'm ticked off too, and I mean it. I'm ticked off that I inherited the mess. I know you're ticked off that we've all inherited the mess and that we've got to deal with it. So there's no kidding around that. No one likes it. But I'd be not doing my job if I said to you that we don't need both the reform and the revenue this year, because without the revenue, I don't know how to solve Senator McGee's problem, Senator Petrocelli's problem, or people who have in Lynn and Saugus and Eastbrook and elsewhere who are facing a dire consequence that no one would want them to face in terms of tunnel tolls. And I can't solve the problem of the folks in this community who use the RTA or who use the T, because as I pointed out, we're going to have to drastically cut back service. And so that's the issue.
Thank you.